Up to this day, we treat depression according to monoamine theory. We believe that depression is caused by deficiency of neurotransmission, which can be caused by low levels of serotonin and norepinephrine and to a lesser extent dopamine in the synapse. So we believe that depression is caused by decreasing amount of serotonin and norepinephrine in the synapse. So how to treat depression? The most obvious approach is to increase the amount of serotonin and norepinephrine in the synapse. And drugs that cause increase in serotonin or norepinephrine in the synapse we call antidepressants. One of the antidepressants called vilazodone. Vilazodone is a typical antidepressant because of his multiple effects. First of all, vilazodone is a partial agonist of serotonin 1-alpha receptor. And to explain this, we have to know how serotonin neurons work. Hit that subscribe button if you have not already, and let's get started. So we have presynaptic neuron, synapse, and postsynaptic neuron. Serotonin neurons uptake tryptophan. Once tryptophan appears inside the neuron, tryptophan undergo hydroxylation by rate-limiting enzyme tryptophan hydroxylase, with formation of serotonin. Once serotonin is formed, vesicular monoamine transporter puts serotonin inside the vesicles, and in this form, serotonin is stored inside the neuron. But once depolarization occurs, neuron pushes vesicle into the synapse. We call this process exocytosis. As a result, vesicle becomes destroyed, and serotonin molecules income to the synapse. On postsynaptic neuron, we have numerous serotonin receptors. And once serotonin appears in the synapse, most of them immediately bind to serotonin receptors. With binding, they activate serotonin receptors, and activation of serotonin receptors improve mood and increase energy. Some of the serotonin molecules bind to serotonin 1-beta receptor on presynaptic neuron, which is autoreceptor. With activation, this receptor inhibits the exocytosis of serotonin vesicles into the synapse. So this receptor provides reciprocal regulation. But what happens to serotonin molecules that simply did not have time to bind to any receptor? On presynaptic neuron, we have a serotonin transporter called SERT. This transporter uptakes free serotonin molecules and delivers them back to the presynaptic neuron, where the big bad boy monoamine oxidase A waiting for them. Most of the delivered serotonin molecules have a tragic fate. Monoamine oxidase uptake and destroy them. But some serotonin molecules are able to slip away from monoamine oxidase, and such molecules income to the newly formed serotonin molecules, thereby replenishing serotonin pool. When patient intakes vilazodone, vilazodone binds to serotonin 1-alpha receptor on presynaptic neuron. Thereby, now serotonin cannot bind to 1-alpha receptor. With binding, vilazodone activates 1-alpha receptor, but vilazodone, unlike serotonin, is just a partial agonist. If serotonin binds to this receptor, a receptor becomes fully activated on 100%. But if vilazodone binds to 1-alpha receptor, a receptor becomes activated only on 50%. And if 1-alpha receptor only half activated, the reciprocal inhibition becomes only half effective. And with decreasing reciprocal inhibition, the exocytosis of serotonin into the synapse increase. And from this moment, step by step, serotonin molecules begin to accumulate in the synapse. In the synapse, serotonin molecules search for serotonin receptors on postsynaptic neuron, and once they bind, they activate them. With time, even more serotonin molecules accumulate in the synapse. Thereby, even more serotonin molecules will bind and activate serotonin receptors. and the higher the stimulation of serotonin receptors, the higher the serotonergic effect, and thereby the better becomes the mood and the more energy increase. So, vilazodone provides partial activation of 1-alpha serotonin receptors. This causes decrease in reciprocal inhibition, thereby the level of serotonin secretion into the synapse increase, and the higher the amount of serotonin molecules in the synapse, the higher the serotonergic effect, and thereby the better becomes the mood and the more energy increase. But in addition to this, vilazodone inhibits the function of serotonin transporter and blocks serotonin type 3 receptor. Vilazodone inhibits the function of serotonin transporter. With inhibition of SERT, the reuptake of serotonin into the presynaptic neuron decreases, so more serotonin molecules will remain in the synapse, where now these free serotonin molecules begin to bind to serotonin receptors, thereby additionally stimulating them. With time, because serotonin transporter is now blocked, in the same fashion, even more serotonin molecules accumulate in the synapse. The higher the amount of serotonin molecules in the synapse, the higher the stimulation of serotonin receptors, and thereby, potentially, the better becomes the mood and the more energy increase. We have to know that we have different subtypes of serotonin receptors. We believe that serotonin type 1 receptor is fully involved in regulation of mood. But also, we have type 2 and type 3 receptors. They also participate in regulation of mood, but to a lesser extent. The specific feature of these receptors are their unique functions. And the specific feature of type 3 serotonin receptor is that with stimulation, this receptor can cause nausea and vomiting. Vilazodone blocks serotonin type 3 receptor. With blockage, serotonin molecules cannot bind to this receptor, and thereby this serotonin receptor cannot be activated. But also, it causes increase in free unbinded serotonin molecules in the synapse. And now, these serotonin molecules will come to the available receptors, including serotonin type 1 receptor. So now, the stimulation of serotonin type 1 receptor becomes even stronger. And because it's the major serotonin receptor involved in regulation of mood, with increasing stimulation of this receptor, mood becomes better and energy increase. In addition to this, because serotonin type 3 receptor is now blocked, nausea and vomiting decrease. We call this antiemetic effect. So, vilazodone inhibits the function of serotonin transporter. This causes decrease in reuptake of serotonin from the synapse. Thereby, the amount of serotonin molecules in the synapse increase. And the higher the amount of serotonin molecules in the synapse, the higher the serotonin effect. And thereby, the better becomes the mood and the more energy increase. And because vilazodone blocks serotonin type 3 receptor, it decreases nausea and vomiting. So there is also mild antiemetic effect. Nowadays, we use vilazodone in major depressive disorder, but only as a second-line option, because as a first-line drugs, we use selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors and serotonin norepinephrine reuptake inhibitors. The major side effect of vilazodone is related to its serotonergic effect and its serotonin syndrome. The problem is that excessive stimulation of serotonin receptors can provoke serotonin syndrome. But if patient intakes just vilazodone, the chances for serotonin syndrome to develop is relatively small. But if we prescribe vilazodone in combination with monoamine oxidase inhibitors, now it becomes dangerous. Because MAO inhibitors block any possibility to destroy excessive serotonin molecules in the presynaptic neuron. And with decrease in serotonin degradation, the total serotonin pool increase, and thereby the amount of serotonin molecules that presynaptic neuron release into the synapse increase. And with increase in amount of serotonin in the synapse, the stimulation of serotonin receptors increase. And now, with such overstimulation of serotonin receptors, the chances of serotonin syndrome greatly increase. And serotonin syndrome manifests with hyperthermia, muscle rigidity, myoclonus, and also it can cause rapid fluctuations in the mental status and vital signs. And we have to remember that prescription of vilazodone with MAO inhibitors, selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, or serotonin norepinephrine reuptake inhibitors greatly increase the risk of serotonin syndrome.